Dave's told me several times that she likes talking to you.
Oh.
Mm-hmm. The time he was putting the furnace in.
Oh. Mm-hmm.
Because he had several times to do that.
Oh, yeah. I was thinking that I should call her and Phyllis Bovey again. She hasn't talked to him for a while now. 7 minutes, you said? Oh.
Mm-hmm. All right, now, you've never been to a dining experience, to say the least. Door County is definitely home to the fish boils. We've been doing traditional fish boils here at the old post office restaurant since 1978 now, so 43 years they've been doing fish boils here at this restaurant.
Wow.
We do this in every single type of weather conditioning, no matter what, so rain or shine, we still do the fish boils even if it's pouring down rain on it. Now, before you guys want to get here, we'll come up with 25 gallons of water, cups of salt go in the water. Salt is the only seasoning you put into a fish boil. That's pretty much all the Norwegian settlers have there. However, that does season everything quite well. The fish, the potatoes, and the onions. You get your fire burning. It takes about a half hour to get that water to really start to boil. Once the water's boiling, you start your timer at 30 minutes. Each fish boil takes a half an hour. Potatoes go in the kettle first, a whole half an hour. Onions go in the kettle second, depending on the size. Fish, you put it for the last 7 minutes. And like I said, the fish we do use, they're fresh. They're local caught Lake Michigan whitefish, caught from both sides of Door County, both Lake Michigan side and Bayside, depending on the time of year. Throughout the summer, almost all the fishing is done way out on the bay. And once the fall rolls around, it all switches over to the Lake Michigan side of the peninsula, just because that's the way all the whitefish schools move around. And we do buy all of our fish from a local fisherman right here in Door County. We get fresh fish delivered just about every other day from a guy named Rick Johnson. He is a fisherman from Gills Rock, which is all the way up at the tip of the peninsula. He's been bringing the restaurant fresh whitefish for almost 40 years now. So just about every other morning, spring,
wow,
summer, fall, rain, or shine, him and his crew get into their boats. They head out to the whitefish nets. And that's all get pulled in by a mechanical winch. The fish can take it back to their little processing facility in Gills Rock. And that's when they clean them all. They head them, gut them, tail them, and scale them there. And then just about every other day between 3 and 4 o'clock, you'll bring fresh whitefish raised in the back door of the restaurant. Rick, the guys can catch them just about every other day. He'll also cut them up for you like this too if you like. They have a machine that does it. Basically a bunch of bandsaw blades. Or you buy them whole and you cut them up all yourself. We always buy our fish whole and then I'll hand cut them all myself with a big razor sharp knife right before I bring them out, put them in the kettle. For every fish boil, it's the best way to do this. Cut the fish up right before you boil them. You buy them pre-cut. Or you can cut them up yourself ahead of time and let them sit and drain a lot of their natural fluids out. They just kind of start to dry out on you and shrink. So it's definitely a little bit more work for me, but it is a much better fish boil for you guys if you do it that way. In an average season, I'll cut out and boil 30,000 Now the fish boil. This is an old Scandinavian tradition. It was started off by Swedish and Norwegian immigrants back in the 1800s up here in Door County. Northern Door County, very rich in Scandinavian heritage. You kind of see it all over up here. Fish boils are a part of that old Scandinavian heritage as well. Most of the Swedes and Norwegians who settled here back in the 1800s, they homesteaded up here in Door County. Basically got free land by the government just to move up to the area to start establishing growth on the Upper Great Lakes. Some of them came up here and fished. Most of them came up here and worked in the logging industry. Those would have been the two jobs back in the 1800s up here in Door County. There was plenty of fish off the water, and the peninsula itself was heavily, heavily forested. Now, I don't think the fish boil was ever really intended to become a tourist attraction like it is today. This would have been done in logging camps and fishing villages back in the 1800s up here in Door County. It probably would have just been an easy way to feed all the Scandinavian immigrants who were starting to settle up here on this remote peninsula. They had plenty of fish in the water. Well, the tables had water, salt, five simple ingredients in a big kettle like this. It would do fish boils like this, and it would have just been used to feed the tiny little communities back in the 1800s up here, which were really nothing more than logging camps and fishing villages at the time. So that's how it all started off. It wasn't until around the turn of the century people started to appreciate all this natural beauty we have up here in Door County. They quit logging all the forests, they started designating areas for state parks, and they started to build and open the first hotels and resorts for tourists, including that one right there, the Edgewater Resort, opened in the year 1900. It was one of the first hotels to open up here in the village of Ephraim. So right around that time, Door County started getting the very first tourists. Unlike today, where we get over 2 million visitors up here every summer, if you came to Door County back in the early 1900s, you came up here on a steamship. They didn't build the highways far north on the peninsula until the late 1920s, so they started to bring tourists up here from Chicago and Milwaukee during the summertime on a steamship. And if you're coming all the way up here from Chicago on a steamship back in those old days, you weren't going to come up for a long weekend like most of you are probably doing right now. It took 12 to 13 hours to get all the way up here. Most of the Mexicans, obviously, up here were very well off, and they'd spend a few weeks up here during the summertime. And back in those days, if you stayed at a resort here in Door County, they cooked all your meals for you while you stayed here as well. They called it the American plan. Well, some of those old resorts and hotels started doing fish boils for their guests, and that's how the tradition was born here in Door County. We've basically been doing fish boils the traditional way, just like this, for the tourists ever since. You can see this does go back well over a century. It's definitely Door County's oldest tradition, and you can date it all the way back to the very first European settlers here in Door County. So it is a pretty neat thing. It stuck around so long. You still do it the traditional way like this, using firewood. And very sweet, and kerosene, which I have right over here. Kerosene thing at the end, probably something that was discovered by accident, I had to guess. But the last thing you do on a fish boil, that is before you go inside to eat it, just a boil over. You get all this stuff cooking in this kettle like this, you start to get this layer of foam, scum, and there's even ash from the fire that simmers to the surface of the kettle. So somebody along the way came up with the boil over, where you throw a can of kerosene into the fire, makes a huge fireball, more importantly makes the whole kettle boil over, and all this foam and gunk from the top goes right along with it. Actually works quite genius. It's going to be a little interesting with this wind blowing her off, but we're going to do it anyhow. After the boil over, you guys go right ahead, walk back between the two buildings, go right to your assigned tables. Everybody gets a plate with a couple of whitefish steaks. You get boiled baby red potatoes, you get boiled onion, you put melted butter all over the top of that, you get homemade bread, homemade coleslaw, and for dessert, a slice of Door County cherry pie. So enjoy. Also, if you need to go, grab one of my flyers if you pass by. I was born and raised up here. I did print off a bunch of stuff. This wind blowing around, you guys are going to want to go behind your benches because it's going to throw.
Well, we had this one beautiful day.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I am too.
Yeah,
I'll watch over this way. Wow. Okay, they got it all. Okay, ice cream. beautiful.
Mm-hmm.
Pushing this and Democrats going along.